Good morning, everyone. I hope you're having a great day. Today, I'd like to share from the Letter of Romans, chapter 8, verse 31 to 39. And if you can, I want to encourage you to read these verses with me. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all. How will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. In today's passage, Paul is making it very clear about who we are in God. Throughout his letter, and chapter by chapter, he has been telling us how we are all sinful by our nature. We are not able to save ourselves. However, this gracious God made us slaves of righteousness through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Yes, he changed our status forever. Furthermore, we have been adopted into God's family through the Holy Spirit who resides in us. We are not under the law of the Old Testament, but we are under his grace. Yes, this is our God who made all these things possible by giving up his own son for us. In today's passage, Paul tells us another important truth that identifies who we are. Through Jesus Christ, we are more than conquerors, which means we not only achieved victory over certain life situations in the past, but we are overwhelmingly victorious. And this is beyond the scope of a regular victory. The type of the victory that Paul is telling us is like the victory of Israel over Egyptians in Exodus. It's the same victory of Jesus over sin and death. Today we are more than conquerors, not by our might, wisdom, or power, but by Jesus Christ who loves us like no other. We may face different life situations, whether that is joy, suffering, success, or hardships. But the love of Christ always remains the same in us, no matter what we go through. And because of this truth, we are more than conquerors in all situations. I pray that you'd find hope and strength in this truth of the gospel. Let's pray. Father God, we give you praise and thanks for the victory that has been won by your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, you've given us everything. And through this passage, we are once again reminded of the width, depth, length, and height of your love. Today, in our circumstances, help us to remember this truth that we are more than conquerors in you.
Give us courage and faith to trust you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.